الحديث 43
حديث 43
عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال
From Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that he said
قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
That Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said
قال الله تعالى
That Allah تعالى says
أنا ثالث الشريكين
I am the third of the two partners
ما لم يخن أحدهما صاحبه
As long as one of them does not betray his companion
فإذا خانه خرجت من بينهما
If he betrays him, then I will come out from between both of them
رواه أبو داود
Narrated by Abu Dawood.
أما أبو هريرة فقد مر في الحديث الرابع.
Abu Huraira, he passed his biography in the fourth hadith.
هذا الحديث يدل على إباحة الشركات لأنه قال أنا ثالث الشريكين يعني تجوز الشركة.
This hadith proves that partnership or companies are allowed because here in this hadith it says I am the third of the two partners.
والشركات أنواع كثير حقيقة.
The companies or partnerships are so many.
منها شركة العنان والأبدان.
The partnership
والوجوه.
Of عنان, أبدان, وجوه.
مضاربة.
مضاربة.
يعني أشرح كل واحدة بكلمتين فقط.
So I will explain each one of them with just a few words.
شركة الأبدان مثلاً.
The partnership based on أبدان. أبدان literally is bodies.
أن يخرج شخصان.
That two people would come
أنا
out.
والشيخ هشام.
And the Sheikh and the brother Sheikh Hisham.
نذهب للصيد.
So we go to hunt, both of us.
هو أخذ جهة اليمين وأنا أخذ جهة الشمال.
He took the right side area and I took the left.
واتفقنا الذي نصيده نقتسمه نصفين.
And we agreed between us that whatever we hunt, both of us, we will share it in half.
فهشام صاد 20 طيرا
هشام he hunted 20 birds
وانا جئت بطيرين
and I brought only two birds
نقتسمها بالنصف تمام
so we shared them in half exactly in half
لان هذه شركة أبدان
because this is a partnership of bodies
وكذلك إذا كان اثنان ينجران مثلا يعملان بالنجارة
likewise if two people are working in carpentry
أو في الحدادة
or they were iron smiths
أو في الكهرباء
or in they were electricians
ويتفقان كل ما يأخذه أحدهما يقسم بينهما بالنصف
and they agree that whatever each one of them will take it will be shared in half between both of them
واحدهما وفق إلى أعمال كثيرة والثاني وفق إلى أعمال قليلة
and one of them Allah facilitated for him many jobs and the other one he only had few jobs
فهذه شركة أبدان
This is again the type of partnership that is called Abdan.
ويجوز أن يتفق يعني على غير 50% إلى 50%.
And it is allowable for them to agree to share not exactly half, more less than that. يعني
حسب الاتفاق.
Other percentage according to what they agree on.
يعني أنا والشيخ هشام مثلاً ذهبنا للصيد.
So me and Sheikh Hisham we went to hunt.
والشيخ هشام ما شاء الله صائد ماهر.
And Sheikh Hisham ما شاء الله is a very good hunter.
أنا.
And myself I am half and half.
فقلت له نشترك في الصيد والذي نصيده نقتسمه 50% 50%.
So we said that okay we go to hunt whatever we catch of the prey we share it half and half 50-50.
فقال لي لا.
He said no.
أنا ماهر في الصيد وأنت لا تعرف الصيد.
I'm very skillful and you are, you know, not that, you know, mediocre.
والدليل صاد 20 وأنا صدت 2.
The proof is he caught 20, I caught only 2.
فقال لي الذي نصيده لي 70% ولك 30%.
Whatever we hunt, he says, I get 70%, you get 30%.
جائز.
It's allowed.
المهم على ما نتفق.
What is important is whatever we agree upon we go by.
وشركة المضاربة.
As for the partnership of مضاربة.
فأنا آتي لشخص ما شاء الله يعني يحسن عمل النجارة.
So I come to a person who is ما شاء الله who is a skillful carpenter.
فأنا أدفع الأموال لشراء المواد.
So I pay the money to buy the materials and the tools.
السيارة التي تنقل
the car that will transport
وهو يعمل بيده.
And he actually works with his hand.
فهذه مضاربة، أحدهما بيده والثاني بماله.
This is what is called مضاربة. One of them works by hand, the other one he has the money, he invests the money.
وشركة الوجوه.
The other partnership is called وجوه.
كل واحد يأخذ بوجهه أي بسمعته بين الناس.
وجوه here plural of وجه يعني faces, but it means the status and the fame with the people, the persons يعني goodwill goodwill
به.
With the people trust him.
كذلك ما نأخذه من الناس بسمعتنا وكذا.
Likewise, whatever we get from the people with our goodwill, with our good reputation.
ونتاجر به.
And we trade with, you used to do business with.
أيضا على اتفاقنا كم النسبة.
According to what we agree on the percentage between us.
والعنان هي التي تجمع هذه الأنواع كلها.
As for what is called partnership of عنان, then it gathers together all of what was mentioned before.
على كل حال كل شركة الأصل فيها الجواز.
Anyway, every partnership, every company, the principle regarding it is that it is allowed.
والأصل في المعاملات الإباحة.
All the principle regarding all the transaction, the transactions or financial transactions, they are allowed. That's the principle.
إلا إذا دخلها ربا أو
unless otherwise it has something prohibited like ربا, treachery or betrayal or gambling or
أي نوع من أنواع البيوع المحرمة.
Any type of prohibited businesses.
وهذا الحديث فيه فضل الشركات لأنها يتعاون بها الناس.
And this hadith mentions indicates the excellence of the partnerships لأنه
تعاون بين الناس
because it, the people help help they cooperate with one another in establishing the business.
قد تكون عندك المهنة وليس عندك المال.
You might have the trade or the skill but you don't have the money.
فالقصد أن الشركات جائزة
the objective here is that those partnerships are allowed
من باب التعاون بين الناس
because of they are of the, from the aspect of the people cooperating and helping, assisting one another.
فيقول النبي صلى الله عليه الله جل في هذا الحديث القدسي.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم or Allah عز وجل in this hadith قدسي.
إذا بنيت هذه الشركات على الصدق والأمانة.
So Allah says here, if these partnerships are based upon truthfulness and honesty and trust.
فإن الله يبارك فيها.
Then Allah عز وجل will bless them.
والعكس صحيح.
And the opposite is true.
إذا دخلتها الخيانة
if betrayal gets involved in this
فنوى أحدهما أو كلاهما خيانة صاحبه
so one of them intends or both of them intend to betray the companion
كان شيخ هشام كشيخ هشام يصيد ويخفي
like شيخ هشام he will hunt and then he will hide what he hunted
أو أنا أصيد وأخفي أنا أصيد وأخفي يلا الله يسامحك.
Or the brother said maybe you do we will do that. The sheikh said okay may Allah forgive you.
يقول الله تبارك خرج الله من بينهما أي لا يبارك في هذا العمل.
So here in the hadith if there is betrayal Allah says that he will get out of this partnership. He is the third of the two partners as long as otherwise he will come out of it.
فالبركة مرتبطة بالأمانة والصدق.
So the blessing is the blessings are attached and linked to trust and honesty and truthfulness.